Hello mga tito at sa mga tita natin dyan na naglalaro syempre ng video games. As we all know, 2020 is a very challenging year for all of us. But our gaming never stops. In fact, there are new mobile games soon to be released and others are being developed to be released this year or sometime next year, maybe. So for now, heto ang top list ko sa mga hinihintay ko na mobile MMORPGs. A3 Still Alive is being published by Netmarble. Netmarble. And developed by Idea Games. This is one game na nasa list ko because ang game na to para sa akin ang pinaka-closest na gameplay sa nilalaro natin na Black Desert Mobile. And hopefully, this will live up sa ating expectation na yung gameplay niya pinaka-closest doon sa nilalaro natin, syempre.
Oh, yeah! But,
sabi ko nga, lahat ng mga online games, may kanya-kanyang trip yan. So dito sa A3 Still Alive, ang mga classes sa game na to ay Berserker, Close Range, High DPS, and Axe Wielder. Templar, Close Range, High Def, or High Defense, Magic User to, Hammer and Shielder. Next one, Wizard, High DPS, Magic User, syempre. Assassin, Agile, and Dual Dagger User. Archer, alam nyo na to. Ang tawag nila sa pet nila ay Soul Linker, which will give you extra stats as the same sa iba nating nilaro na games. Pets will always boost your stats or will always aid you in your battles sa mobs or boss fights. The character name reservation is on October 26, kung hindi ako nagkakamali, 1 PM PH time. And as of now, ongoing ang pre-registration nila and you may have the chance to win mobile phones and a MacBook Pro. Release date, we announce. But the website kung saan pwede kang mag-pre-register and name reserve, nasa link below. Silkroad Online is being published by U1 Game from Hong Kong and developed by Joymax.
Wow.
This is one of the classic PC games like 10 years ago, if I'm not mistaken. And was published way back by Level Up Games here in the Philippines. Now, we will experience it on mobile. My expectation is that adjustments on gameplay will be made, of course, and it has changed its platform to mobile. And hopefully, the intense boss battles, storyline, and open-world adventure is as close to its predecessor, which is, of course, the PC version. As of now, on their website, there are 3 initial classes that you can choose from. You can be a high DPS close range, high defense shielder, and of course, the archer. Pre-registration event is ongoing. Initially, this should be released sometime later this October. However, due to the change of C region gaming policy, the game release was delayed. Don't worry, Silk Road, we will be waiting for you. Their website on the link below. Granado Espada. Again, this is one of the classic PC games from way back 10 years ago. And again, was published by Level Up Games here in the Philippines. This was released way back 2006, if I'm not mistaken, sa South Korea and was developed by IMC Games. status sa mga games na ina-addikan natin syempre noon. Ang gameplay nito ay bubuo ka ng isang team or isang trio. For example, one gunner, one close range, and one magic user. Pwede rin dalawang gunner, tapos isang tanker. Magkakasama tong trio na to sa open world adventure, killing mobs, boss fights, and of course, PvP. This is currently being developed to be on the mobile platform. But surprisingly, the PC version is still playable on Steam. Release date, as I've mentioned, underdeveloped pa yung game na to or ongoing yung development pala. So, to be announced pa yung release date. Noah's Heart, another open world MMO RPG na anime style. Parang Genshin Impact, but without the real-time character changing option. This is developed by Arcosaurus Games, and according to our source, the open world or the map has a size of initially 64 million meters, sabi sa source. And yes, mobile game po ito. Isa ito sa mga top games ko kasi ito yung MMORPG na anime style closest to Genshin Impact. Pero yung Genshin Impact, it's an RPG game. Ito naman, MMORPG. May mga sabi sa source natin, no? May mga secret and special quest daw to. And NPC bonding. Parang amity sa BDM. Parang ganun. Also, may mga NPC quest na kapag na-deads or namatay daw yung NPC sa quest, ang death nito ay permanent. Hindi na ito mabubuhay and the quest will still progress based on the decision you made while going on yung quest. Parang AI. Yun. This is expected to be released middle of 2021. RF Online Mobile. Kung kailangan ko mag-explain to. Again, this is one of the classic MMORPG PC games 10 years ago and again was published by Level Up Games dito sa Pinas. This was developed by CCR. This is my first love MMORPG. Oh, na-addict na naman ako dito. Nakita nyo dati naglalaro ako nito eh. Naalala ko dati, way back, Level Up Games pa yung publisher, subscription based po siya nung unang release niya dito sa Pinas. Yung bibili ka ng 100 pesos level up card to play the game for 5 days. Tapos kung gusto mo ulit maglaro, kailangan mong bumili pa ng 100 pesos level up card game para mag top up, para makapag-subscribe sa game and then tuloy-tuloy lang yung laro mo. So, but currently, Netmarble na naman. They have acquired the rights to publish the game as a mobile game. Yes, RF Online in the future can now be played on our smartphones. This is an ongoing development. So yung gameplay nito, may three races siya, namely the Christian Empire, Holy Alliance of Gora, and the Velato Federation, of course. And you get to choose different classes from each race. And each race has a special class. This is a three-way war. Kada 8 hours, may cheap war na nagaganap sa isang map na pagkaagawan ninyo. Ang name ng map, of course, Krag Mine. Ito yung mining area for the resources to upgrade your gears. The economy is also driven by the players, which is ito yung kinagandaan ng game na to. You can check my PvP video of RF Online, PC version of course, on the description below. Release date to be announced. So, marami pang games ang darating sa mobile. At ang lagi ko ang sinasabi, kanyang-kanyang trip lang yan. Kung trip mo yung isang game na to, hindi ka naman pwedeng mapilit na maglaro pa ng isang game, di ba? Kanya-kanyang trip lang yan. Okay? So, kita-kits sa mga games na to. And don't forget to subscribe for more upcoming videos. Thank you for watching. Kita-kits.